you? Only the times where they use Taiwan English, not American English.
We had PE, but we just ran the track 4 times, that's it.
Experience middle school.
Yeah!
This is gonna be fun, right? What are we doing? What kind of classes are we gonna have?
So we're going to have American Club.
American Club?
And okay. Then we're going to English class for Taiwan.
And then you're gonna have my PE class.
PE class?
And then my PE class.
No, 2 English and 2 PE, the ones I don't want. Okay, and then is that lunch?
Then we break for lunch.
Yes. My favorite subject is lunch.
For about 1 hour. And then I believe you'll go to his class.
Yeah, you'll go to my class. It's like society.
And then you'll have a Chinese and math with me.
Why does this sound like a day in hell? Okay, let's get started. Let's go, guys.
Yeah.
All right.
How long do you have to clean for?
10 minutes in the morning and 20 minutes in the afternoon.
What? 30 minutes a day?
Yeah.
That's kind of a lot,
huh? 今天就是这个企划，其实蛮兴奋的。就是哎，我想看一下台湾跟美国的国中的差别在哪里，这样子。那我已经注意到一个非常大的差别，就是说我们在美国不可能说一大早来学校然后再打扫。还有一个点就是蛮特别的，是说我们在美国想穿什么就穿什么，可是这里是要穿制服，然后每一个这边都会有你自己的号码什么的。哎，真的是跟我们美国的制度有点不太一样，蛮酷的。
What are you doing?
Checking
homework.
10页。
然后我还要发现一件事情，就是班上所有的小朋友，就是感觉好像已经习惯在没有冷气的环境下，然后我跟就是一直流汗。
Looking back, what I really wanted them to do is experience the culture, something different. I didn't want them to be sheltered away, you know, living in the house and not really experience, you know, what other kids' life here. And I thought the best way of doing that was, you know, sending them to school.
在班上，我觉得他是很乐意去观察大家在做什么，一边跟着做，一边增进他的中文。啊，另外班上也是愿意去，像我之前一开始就是请他们每个要去跟 Dylan 讲句话，问他一个问题。然后 Dylan 非常 nice， 说什么问题都可以问，所以就是让他们也练习做英文的小小的对话。
国小就是有知道 Dylan 在我们的国小，但是不同班。到国中我也没有想过会跟 Dylan 同班，所以有惊讶到一下。会想要跟他们学，但是有怕自己英文会太烂，但是没有办法跟他学。然后怕跟他沟通这样。
现在是社团时间，然后我们社团是英文社团，所以 OK 的，轻松。So what kind of clubs do you have? Like aside from English, what else is there?
You have drone club.
Drone club?
Yeah.
Like the camera kind or like a drone drone?
I think it's a camera kind.
Why did you choose English?
I didn't. I was forced.
Why were you forced?
Dad wanted me to use my Chinese.
Okay, so then I'll go with you, okay? We'll do everything in Mandarin together.
Okay.
High five.
Yeah. 现在是英文社团，但是因为我英文已经够厉害了，真的是所以呢，我就练习我的破中文。那我的破中文的一些字体，你给几分哦？很多人都说我的字都像小孩子，然后很多人说。
English class.
More English?
Is it a challenge for you? Only the times where they use Taiwan English, not American English.
For like what?
Grammar.
Oh, Taiwan grammar?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's go see. Come on.
with the accident. I would say John and his friends have nothing to do with the accident.
Yeah.
It's a little bit overcomplicated, but I like this teacher's jinsen. So funny.
So we just finished our second English class and now it's time for me to go to pee. But there's something I noticed. You will stay in this classroom, right? Like you won't leave. Because in the States, I remember when I was in middle school, the teachers stay in the classroom and the people, the kids have to switch, right? So they don't do that here? Pee!
No, they don't.
They don't switch classes, so you stay in this classroom all day long?
The only classes I can think of are sometimes home economics,
okay.
Definitely living technology,
okay.
Computer class.
So like the specialty PE. Classes, you yeah. need extra tools, you have to go to their class. Mm-hmm. But for the most part, you stay here in your class?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go, PE class.
其实之前都想象不到会有这一生可以遇到美国人，刚开始挺错愕的，然后也不敢跟他搭话，因为怕自己的英文太烂，没办法跟他沟通。就后来第一次沟通之后，发现哎，其实我讲的话听得懂，然后也是在这个方面我奠定了我就是英文的基础，这样子就我也了解到自己英文的功力到什么程度。我很多时候其实会硬拉着他去找其他班的同学，对，因为他可能不会沟通，或者是其他同学跟他沟通上面有一些隔阂，有没有？那我就是担任翻译官一职，这样子就是在中间做翻译。
What they do?
We had a PE, but we just ran the track 4 times. That's it.
That's it? Run 4 times and then nothing else?
No, and then we just played.
That sounds like fun. 我刚刚结束了第一节 PE 课，体育课，然后等一下还要再一个体育课。哇，好吧 ，Let's go.可以赶快下课，因为连续两个体育课真的很累。
你不觉得变年轻了？
没有，我只觉得我是球场最老的，也最没有体力的。
现在是午餐时间。What are you gonna eat today?
I brought my own lunch.
You brought your own lunch? Do you know they have fried chicken in there?
No, I don't care.
You don't care? You don't like fried chicken?Dylan, when you were in school in the States, did they eat in the classrooms or did they eat in the cafeteria?
Cafeteria.
Really? So is it weird for you eating in the classroom?
Not anymore.
Not anymore? In the beginning, was it?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay, let's go eat.
Yay.
Yay!
像举例来说，第一个我那个时候一开始有很多表单要签，那我们的小孩可能就拿回他家给家长签，他不会看内容。但是 Dylan 的妈妈是带他一条条都是中文哦，用 Google 翻译翻译成英文，确认每一条都没问题的，他们才签名。有问题的还拿来学校问我。那我就跟小朋友说，这次他们觉得签名就是一个你要保证，所以他们应该也要练习把这个内容都看过。对对对，这是第一个我发现的不一样。那另外一个是尊重彼此的问题。那时候我们班上有班群的赖班群，为了以防停课，那同学看到 Dylan 很兴奋。就一直把他加成好友，但是 Dylan 会觉得说，你们要先征询过我的意见，然后再加我好友才是比较礼貌的方式。
我们现在要去上的是什么课？
公民课。
什么是公民课？啊 ？Really? Okay, well, we'll see what is 公民课。Dylan 他们班上就是看到一个超级可爱又很感动，对我来说是很感动的一个画面，就是说刚刚 Dylan 他们分小组，然后他们要报告，然后 Dylan 在念他的那个报告的台词的时候，他的同学就一个一个帮着他看，然后他不会的会教他这样子，然后我就觉得这个同学不只是就是真的很有耐心的在教，他也是愿意去帮助他，也不会说觉得很不耐烦，或是觉得说哦好烦哦，我不想帮他。他们是很热情的在帮忙，这个点我就看得出来，就是 他们在班上真的是很幸福，然后台湾的小孩不会说因为你跟我们不一样而欺负你，或者而觉得对你不耐烦之类的，真的是很感动。我知道我讲了感动讲了100次，但是我真心是觉得非常非常感动。你们现在要上什么课？
数学。
数学课？你数学很厉害吗
？No.
Which one's harder, American math class or Chinese math class?
Taiwan math because I don't know the Chinese.
Oh yeah, yeah, that makes sense. It's okay, you got this. 加油。
What do you think is one of like the hardest things you guys have had to overcome in this school?
Language barrier. My math tests were like 40, 30, 20, and then I'm like, huh, I better look at the words. Oh, 60, 60, 65, ugh. They're not the best, but they're better than what they were.
翻成中文会有时候是看一些字不知道它什么意思，我们要去猜，所以我觉得就算中文程度再好，其实这一个数学课是对我们来说是蛮难的，就觉得哥哥辛苦了。
Yes.
我发现中文课对我来说有点太难，然后我们该上的是这一本。这一本，但是戴瑞克嘞，他在上这个，然后他自己给自己一些功课，然后自己在那边写中文字。可是我觉得不错，就是他知道现在是国文课，应该要学国文，然后他就自己在旁边练习。那这个时候我觉得就是很可惜，是他跟不上脚步，但是也很不错，是他很努力的想要追上大家，然后也很认真在练习。我没想到，就是学校里面真的有一个小小的福利社，超可爱的，而且真的有芊芊推荐的苹果面包。然后除了苹果面包以外，这个是我想买的巧克力面包烤。哎，饮料感觉不错哦，但是我只要一个巧克力面包。现在已经下课时间，然后就是一开始我的感觉是可能老师会很凶，然后就是要一直写功课，几乎没在玩，然后几乎没有休息时间。但是我发现就是国中的生活其实跟我想的完全是相反的，每一个老师都很友善，然后其实外国人不会因为我们是外地来的而被歧视，我们其实是大家在台湾会很欢迎外国人，然后也会就是对我们很好。像是我在最后一堂课的时候跟哥哥一起的时候，国文课其实对我来说是有一点点难度。旁边的同学他没有跟我讲话，然后也没有让我作弊，但是他会看着我一下，我有没有翻到对的那一页，或者是就是有没有写对答案之类的。然后感觉好像真的是有一个被照顾的感觉。那不只是我，就是哥哥跟弟弟也都是。我不知道。我就觉得真的很棒，然后而且我觉得他们有这个机会真的是非常非常的好，也谢谢今天学校来让我们来到这边，然后让我们拍摄一整天，然后跟着他们上课，看看他们上课的状况，然后有几个老师也有过来跟我们聊天，我都觉得可以看得出他们对哥哥看弟弟的付出，所以我觉得很棒。
有时候就是班上来到了一个比较特殊的学生，有时候真的会觉得怎么办怎么办，可是我觉得你真的很棒。
我刚开始也蛮紧张的，但是他让我感觉很棒。对对，很开心有他在我们班上，我有跟他讲过 I hope you could be better and we can graduate together.
然后中文要加油。
I think that they're probably the luckiest boys on earth. How many people get to say that, you know, you as a teenager went to foreign school, learning the language, making friends and having a good time? I think that just, you can tell that story for the rest of your life.
谢谢大家收看，如果喜欢我们这支影片，一定要记得要订阅，可以追踪我们的 IG 和 FB， 可以看到更多的生活照，或是可以看到我们在拍什么样的内容，可以提前看到，所以都可以去追踪哦。谢谢大家收看，拜拜。